So, hello friends, welcome to this beautiful course of industrial pollution. This is Ashutosh Kumar, and now I am going to start the third lecture of first module, which is introduction. In today's lecture, I am going to discuss what is ecosystem, what are the various ecological terms, that is habitat, population, community and niche, and what are the various biotic and abiotic factors, and what is ecology and its types. So we are going to discuss above items in today's lecture. Now let us start. Now what is ecosystem? So an ecosystem includes all the living organisms that interact with one another and also with the physical and non-physical factors present. If you look at this figure, this is a simple ecosystem in which we have living things as well as we have non-living things. So living things include tree, living thing also include this animal, and non-living things include the cloud, rain, oxygen, sunlight. So these all are non-living things. So what ecosystem means? That is interaction of all living organism with one another at the same time with all the physical and non-physical factors present. So for better understanding of ecosystem, we have to understand what are the four avastha in the nature. So is pure prakriti mein char avasthaye hain, pure brahmand mein char avasthaye hain, iske alawa aur koi avastha nahi hai jo main discuss karne ja raha. Pehla avastha hai padarth avastha. Padarth avastha mein mitti hai, pani hai, hawa hai, khanij lavan hai aadi, ye sare padarth avastha hai. दूसरा जो अवस्था है वो है प्राणी अवस्था, जिसमें पेड़ पौधे आते हैं. तीसरी जो अवस्था है वो है जीव अवस्था, जिसमें पशु और पक्षी आते हैं. और जो चौथा सबसे उन्नत अवस्था है वो है मानव अवस्था, जिसमें स्त्री और पुरुष आते हैं. तो अभी हम इस चारों अवस्थाओं को डिस्कस करेंगे और हम देखेंगे कि ये अवस्थाएं कैसे एक दूसरे से लिंक है. तो जैसा कि हम सभी जानते हैं, ये जो पदार्थ अवस्था है, ये पदार्थ अवस्था जिसमें मिट्टी, हवा, पानी और खनिज है, ये निर्जीव है. दे आर नॉन लिविंग फैक्टर्स ऑफ इकोसिस्टम. एज आई अर्लियर डिस्कस्ड, दे आर नॉन लिविंग फैक्टर्स ऑफ इकोसिस्टम. नाउ प्राणी अवस्था, देयर इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन प्राणी अवस्था एंड जीव अवस्था. सो दिस प्राणी अवस्था, दीज अवस्था, पेड़ पौधे कम्स अंडर प्राणी अवस्था. सो पेड़ पौधे अचल हैं, चल नहीं सकते हैं, लेकिन दे आर लिविंग फैक्टर्स, दे आर लिविंग थिंग्स. जीव अवस्था, पशु पक्षी चल सकते हैं, दे आर लिविंग थिंग्स. मानव अवस्था, जो इन तीनों अवस्थाओं में और चारों अवस्थाओं में सबसे उत्तम है, वो भी लिविंग थिंग्स. तो इस चारों अवस्था के अलावा इस पूरे ब्रह्मांड में, पूरे पृथ्वी में कोई अवस्था उपलब्ध नहीं है. अब हम देखते हैं कि प्राणी अवस्था के लिए पदार्थ अवस्था का होना जरूरी है. प्राणी अवस्था जैसे कि पेड़ और पौधे, बिना मिट्टी, पानी, हवा और खनिज लवण के पेड़ पौधों का होना संभव नहीं है. उसी तरह से जो जीव अवस्था है, इसके लिए प्राणी अवस्था का भी होना जरूरी है, साथ ही साथ पदार्थ अवस्था का भी होना जरूरी है. पशु पक्षियों के लिए मिट्टी भी चाहिए, हवा चाहिए, पानी चाहिए और खनिज लवण चाहिए. इसी के साथ साथ पशु और पक्षी के लिए पेड़ और पौधे की भी जरूरत है. जैसे घोड़ा घास खाता है, यानी कि जितने भी पशु और पक्षी हैं, पेड़ और पौधे उनके लिए जरूरत है. लेकिन जो थर्ड, चौथी अवस्था, मानव अवस्था, जिसमें स्त्री और पुरुष आते हैं, उस अवस्था के लिए इस तीनों अवस्था का होना बहुत जरूरी है. जैसे मानव के लिए मिट्टी, एग्रीकल्चर के लिए मिट्टी चाहिए, हवा चाहिए, पानी चाहिए और खनिज मिनरल्स चाहिए. मानव के लिए पेड़ पौधे चाहिए, अगर पेड़ और पौधे नहीं होंगे तो ऑक्सीजन कहाँ से आएगा. तो मानव के लिए पदार्थ अवस्था भी चाहिए, प्राणी अवस्था भी चाहिए और जीव अवस्था भी चाहिए। जीव अवस्था पशु पक्षी, पशुओं से हमको बहुत सारा, जैसे गाय से हमको दूध मिलता है, तो ये चार अवस्थाएं हैं। तो इकोसिस्टम को समझने के लिए इन चार अवस्थाओं को समझना जरूरी था, जो हमने समझा। नाउ हम अब आगे बढ़ते हैं। नाउ वी हैव टू डिस्कस व्हाट आर द वेरियस इकोलॉजिकल टर्म्स। सो मेजर देयर आर फोर इकोलॉजिकल टर्म्स एंड द फर्स्ट टर्म इज हैबिटेट, द सेकेंड टर्म इज पॉपुलेशन, द थर्ड वन इज कम्युनिटी एंड द फोर्थ वन इज नीस। सो लेट अस डिस्कस ऑल दीज इकोलॉजिकल टर्म्स इन डिटेल। सो फर्स्ट वन इज हैबिटेट। सो वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ हैबिटेट? सो हैबिटेट इज नथिंग बट द नेचुरल होम और इन्वायरमेंट ऑफ एनी एनिमल, प्लांट और एनी ऑर्गेनिज्म। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, फॉर दिस बर्ड नेस्ट इज देयर नेचुरल होम, फॉर दिस स्नेक डिसर्ट इज और डिजर्ट इज देयर नेचुरल होम। सो हैबिटेट इज नथिंग बट द नेचुरल होम और इन्वायरमेंट ऑफ एन एनिमल, प्लांट और एनी लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म। सो द हैबिटेट मे बी डिजर्ट, इट मे बी फॉरेस्ट, इट मे बी ग्रासलैंड, इट मे बी आईलैंड, इट मे बी माउंटेन्स, ओशंस एंड वेटलैंड। सो हैबिटेट्स, दीज हैबिटेट्स पॉसिबल फॉर लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स। नाउ हैबिटेट्स ऑफ एनिमल एंड स्पीसीज, वी कैन लुक एट दीज फॉरेस्ट। सो इन फॉरेस्ट हैबिटेट वेरियस forest animals like elephant, lion, zebra, giraffe, they all are residing in a forest habitat. Now, desert habitat, many animals, they are living in desert, so their habitat is desert. Now, many aquatic animals living in oceans, so their habitat is ocean. And many other like germs, then bacteria, they are living underground, like they are living below the earth surface, so their habitat is underground, earth surface. If we talk about coronavirus, so for coronavirus the habitat is human being. We are the habitat of coronavirus. Coronavirus only survives when it enters in a particular body. Coronavirus cannot survive outside the body. Like for, if you talk about metal, if you talk about plain paper, then there are different timing. Like in plain paper, coronavirus survive for 12 hours. In metallic, it may survive for 72 hours. But in human body, it may survive for longer. And that will cause death to the person. Now, habitat of different species. So in deserts is a habitat of lizards, geckos, toads, camels, snakes, spiders. So these are the desert is the habitat of these animals. Now neem, sisam, palash, tiger, then elephant, jackal, these all like I earlier discussed that plant is also comes under living organism. So for these all items or animals or organisms, forest is their habitat. Now, if you talk about grassland, so zebra and antipodes, their habitat is grassland. If you talk about island, so green turtle, penguins, and crabs, their habitat is island. Now, mountain, if you talk about mountain, so mountain lion, yellow-bellied marmot, their habitat is mountains. Now, if you talk about ocean, so aquatic animals, their habitat is ocean. Now, wetland, so alligators, snakes, turtles, and amphibians, these are animals which are living in a wetland. So these I have discussed the habitat of various species which are found on this planet. Now we have to understand the second ecological term, which is population. So what is population? Population, I am talking about not general population. This is a population, means this is related to ecosystem. So population is a group of organisms, all of the same species and all of the whom live together in a particular habitat is called a population of that habitat. Like if you look at this figure, these are the group of zebra or herd of zebra. These are the group of giraffe. So they all are living in a particular area and they are living in a particular habitat. So they are called population of that habitat. Now community. So the total population living together in a particular habitat. Like as I earlier discussed, these zebra, these are called the particular habitat of zebra. These are called the particular habitat of giraffe. So the total all population living together in a particular habitat is called community. So if you talk about this elephant, so what are the number of elephants in that habitat is called community of that habitat. So you think it is nothing but the number of organism living in that habitat. Now the fourth ecological term is niche. So we have to understand what niche is. So the position occupied by an organism or animal in a particular ecosystem. Like for example, as I earlier discussed, there are four avastha in this nature, which is padarth avastha, prani avastha, jeev avastha and manav avastha. So out of these four avastha, human is superior. So their niche will be more. They occupy better position in a niche. So the position occupied by an organism, animals in a particular ecosystem, dependent upon the resources it uses. Like an animal uses less resource than a human. So in a niche system, our position will be more or at higher level. The more resources that are taken into account, then the more carefully defined the organism niche will be. The organism will become more specialized. Like if you look at this figure, these all are insects and they live in a particular ecosystem. So what are their position in the particular ecosystem and what resource, what natural resource these insects are using for their survival? So if any particular species or organism uses more resource for their survival, then we can say that in niche their position is higher. Now if you look at African savanna is nothing but a grassland. So in African savanna, following animals are found, like lions, zebra, giraffe, elephant. So all these animals live together on the same grassland. This is very important. Means I am repeating it again. In African savanna jungle, savanna grassland, following animals are found like lions, zebra, giraffe, elephant. And all animals live on same grassland, but they play different role in the ecosystem and occupies different niche in the ecosystem. Like suppose if there is hunting of an animal like a hyena or dog or monkey like that. Suppose lion hunts some animal. So what is the share of meat or share of that portion to the lion? This is called the niche of this grassland. So if their resource utilization of a particular animal in the particular ecosystem will be more, then we can say that the position of that animal in that ecosystem is more. So again, the above animal, they live in the same grassland, but they play a different role in a ecosystem and they occupy different niche in the ecosystem. Now what are the biotic and abiotic factors of ecosystem? So biotic components are the living factors of ecosystem. Like I earlier discussed, all four avastha of this nature I earlier discussed. So all biotic factors are living factors. Like plants are living factors or living components or living things. Animals are living things. we person, we peoples are living things. Fungus, they are living things. Bacteria, they are living things. Virus, they are living things. Protozoa, they are living things. All living things are biotic components of the ecosystem. We can also look at this figure, like this is plant, animal, bacteria, fungus, protozoa. Now, what are the abiotic factors of ecosystem? So abiotic factors are those factors which are non-living things. For example, water is non-living, soil is non-living, air is non-living, minerals is non-living, light is non-living. But for survival of biotic system, abiotic factors is required. Without abiotic factors, survival of biotic factors cannot be possible. So again, I am repeating, abiotic factors are those factors which are non-living factors, and they are chemically and physically present in a ecosystem. Like water is physically present in the ecosystem, air, mineral, all these are either chemically or physically present in the ecosystem. So these all are abiotic factors of ecosystem. Now, these are the examples earlier discussed in a single slide. So these are biotic factors or biotic living things. These are abiotic, which is non-living things. So in living things, we can animals, these animals, plant, protozoa, fungus, bacteria. In non-living things, soil, water, light, mineral, air. So for survival of these biotic factors, these abiotic factors is required. Without this, the existence of this cannot be possible on this planet. Now, the next topic is ecology. So we have already understood what ecosystem is. So ecosystem is nothing but it includes all living organisms that interact with one another, with all physical and non-physical factors present. So ecology is a branch of science, including human science, population, community, ecosystem, and biosphere. It is the study of organism, environment, and how the organism interact with each other and their environment. Like if we talk about a animal like cow, so how cow interact with environment? Cow gets oxygen from tree, a cow gets grass from land or from farmland, and a cow gives us milk. So how a particular animal cow interact with environment? So the study of any animal on this planet and what is their interaction, how they interact with the environment or with any species, like we are also a species on this planet. So how a cow is linked to us, how a cow affect us, how any animal affect us. So this is the study of ecology. Now, what is the goal of ecologist? So the ecologist's primary goal is to improve their understanding of life processes, adaptations and habitats, interactions and biodiversity of organisms. If you look at butterfly life cycle, then we can see this, that first eggs comes, first butterfly eggs come, and from eggs, caterpillar or larva comes. It is a, you can say, improvement or eggs. The next stage is larva. The third stage is pupa, and the fourth stage is butterfly. Again, butterfly lay eggs on leaf, and this cycle completes. So the ecologist try to understand that how these processes occur in the ecosystem and what are the effect of these processes on the ecosystem. And the main aim of ecology is to understand the distribution of biotic and abiotic factors of living things in the environment. So the ecology also aims at how biotic and abiotic factors affect our environment and what are their contribution in the environment. Now, types of ecology. So There are six types of ecology. The first one is global ecology. The second one is landscape ecology. Third one is ecosystem ecology. Fourth one is community ecology. Fifth one is population ecology. And the sixth one is organismal ecology. Now let us discuss all these types one by one. Now let us discuss global economy. So the global economy is nothing but the interaction among earth ecosystem, atmosphere, land and ocean. How earth ecosystem interact with atmosphere, how earth ecosystem interacts with land, and how earth ecosystem interact with ocean. And the global ecology helps us in understanding the large scale interaction and their influence on the planet. So what are the large scale interaction of earth ecosystem on this planet? These are covered under global ecology. Now the second is landscape ecology. So landscape is the study of exchange of energy, organism, materials, and other products of ecosystem. So as I earlier discussed, in ecosystem we have organisms, we have, if organism is there then energy is there. So how these energy, organism, material and other products, how their exchange happens, and their study comes under landscape ecology. So landscape ecology throws light on the role of human impacts on the landscape structure and function. If you talk about this landscape, so this landscape is agricultural landscape. So how this landscape affect the ecosystem? So this concept or this study comes under landscape ecology. Now we have to also understand what is the meaning of landscape. So let us discuss what is the meaning of landscape. So landscape is nothing but an area that consists of more than one ecosystem. So it is an area which consists of more than one ecosystem. If you talk about this natural landscape, so in this landscape, what are the factors we can see? So we can see these waters or these water. We can see one bridge is there. We can see some forest or trees are there. So we can see living things. Also we can see non-living things. So how these living things and these non-living things, they interact with each other. So this is natural landscape. So these are the examples of natural landscape, and the study of their interaction is called a natural landscape or landscape ecology. Now, ecosystem ecology. So the ecosystem or the study of ecosystem, entire ecosystem, which includes the study of living and non-living components and their relationship with the environment. In this science research, how ecosystem work and interacts. Like this entire planet or this entire you can say system, suppose we consider this as an ecosystem. So we can see some plant community is there, then habitat is there, rain is there, sunlight is there, solar radiation is there. So these all makes a ecosystem. So the study of the entire things and how habitat is affecting, how solar radiation is affecting the habitat, how rain is affecting habitat. So these study comes under ecosystem ecology. Now community ecology. So community ecology, as I earlier discussed, the term community, which means total of population living together in a particular habitat. So the total population living in a particular habitat is called community. Now, community ecology is nothing but the study of how community structure changed by interaction among living organisms. ecology community is made up of two or more population of different species living in a particular geographical area. Like, suppose this is a animal, so this is called organism. This animal is called organism, and these are the population of this particular organism. And now community means various animal groups. They like zebras are there, like deer or animals are there. So these all lions are there. So these all make one community of animal community. So the study of all these and how they interact comes under community ecology. And these all are ecosystem. Now, the fifth one is population ecology. So the population ecology is the study of factors that change and impact the size and genetic composition of the population of organisms. Like, if you look at this figure, these are the human skull. So how there changes in size and weight of human skull, these we study in a population ecology. So the primary goal of population ecologist or the ecologist who study population is to ascertain what are the various factors which decides the size and weight of the human brain over period of time. Now, ecologists are interested in fluctuation in the size of a population, the growth of a population, and any other interaction with the population. So in population ecology, in a simple word, an ecologist see that or how size, their weight of a particular community or a particular population affect the ecosystem. Now, organismal ecology. Now, organismal ecology is the study of individual organism behavior, their morphology, their physiology in response to environmental challenges. Like we human, how we change it as our ecosystem changes. Like if you go to South India, the skin color of peoples are dark. If you go to Western country, the skin color of peoples are very fair. So the reason is that their ecosystem affects their body. So in organismal ecology, we study how individual organisms interact with biotic and abiotic components. Now, summary of ecology. So this first is global ecology, which comes first. That is the global interaction of this planet or their ecosystem. Then from global ecology, landscape ecology comes. After landscape ecology, ecosystem ecology comes. Then community ecology comes. Then population ecology comes. And last one is organismal ecology. Now, importance of ecology. Why ecology is important for all of us? So conservation of environment. As we know that in last couple of decades, a lot of erosion of forest or environment happens. So conservation of environment is important. So if we study ecology, then ecologists find the way how conservation, how environment can be conserved. Now next is soil conservation. As we all know that our primary objective on this planet is survival. And without soil, survival of human cannot be possible. So soil conservation is also important for ecology point of view. Now, resource allocation. If we not allocate resource properly, then what will happen? There will be imbalance. Now, energy conservation. Energy conservation is also important for ecology point of view. And the last one is eco-friendliness. So eco-friendliness is also important. So these are the five factors. These are the five importance of ecology. Now, difference between ecosystem and ecology. Many students confused and they are saying that ecosystem and ecology both are same. So both are not same, there are certain different. So let us first describe what ecosystem. So as we earlier discussed, an ecosystem include all the living organisms that interact with one another and also with physical and non-physical factors present. So ecosystem is a how living organisms, this is very important, how only living organism, not non-living organism. So how living organism interacts with one another at the same time with physical and non-physical factors present. But at the same time, ecology is a branch of science, including human science, population, community, ecosystem, and biosphere. So it is a science. Like again, the second definition of ecology is, it is the area in which living and non-living things interact with each other and one another. Whereas ecology, it is the study of ecosystem. It means how the interaction between the organism is happening. So these are the differences between ecosystem and ecology. So I hope you have liked this video lecture. And in next video lecture, we will complete the next content of the syllabus of industrial pollution. And thank you, all of you. And we will meet you in a next lecture, that is lecture number 4. Thank you.